Fellow dear friends, wherever you are at this moment, I'm here now with a very important topic. I believe that every one of you as a dear friend may have something to say, but please be constructive. Don't insult anybody. We don't condone insult. Don't insult anybody. Don't insult anybody. But if you want to make contribution, you want to make suggestion, you want to comment, make your comment reasonable, make it constructive. So here we go. This time there is this interview I watched on the social media between Simon Ekpa and a Yoruba man who is a retired lieutenant colonel. All right? So, I think I know that Yoruba man when I was in Nigeria military. So he, as Simon Ekpa was having a program, call it a fact file, call it updating Biafran's what is about to come and what has happened and what will happen now. So I wish he left the line open so that anybody who have a question or who is not convinced or who don't understand what he mean can call him on the line on the phone, so as to find out really what he is saying and how it will be done. So this is phone call. All right. You can see Simon Ekpa himself. You can see the man. He was inside the vehicle making the call. So he was asking Simon Ekpa, that is the Nigeria retired lieutenant colonel, he was asking Simon Ekpa, can anything be done so that he will abandon Biafra agitation? Can anything be done in Nigeria for Simon Ekpa to abandon Biafra agitation? So then Simon Ekpa answered him, no. That is with a capital letter, no, N-O. Nothing can be done for him to stop Biafra agitation. And Simon Ekpa asked him, why are you asking and why are you saying what you are saying? He said, the Yoruba retired colonel said that he knew that what Simon Ekpa is saying and what he is doing is right. And he knew that was what Mazen Nnamdi Kanu is doing was right. It's right. That from his own angle, he has written constitutions looking at his level in military and in education, that he understood it clearly that Nigeria Constitution of 1999 is not for human being. It does not have human face. That it is not a constitution. Are you getting it now? That he know that the constitution of Nigeria is not human, it's not for human being. It doesn't have human face. And now that he want Simon Ekpa and he to be able to build Nigeria. On the other hand, he want to bring his constitution, the one he wrote, which he presented to Nigerians. Let them remove this 1999 own and use his own. Or look into what he has drafted. And someone ever asked him, then what did Nigeria answer you? So, the man was somehow speechless. You understand? So, but I want to say something before I continue. This man, as a lieutenant colonel, he is. In his position, he is not a junior officer. He is a senior officer. He is one of the authority in the military hierarchies. But we have major generals. We have lieutenant generals. Those who are ahead of him and those who senior him in the military and in age. So, why is it so that those people did not react the way he is seeing Nigeria? Why is it so that those people ahead of him cannot say anything? Are you getting it now? And I want to say, is it now Simon Ekpa, Mazenamde Kanu, and many Biafrans started for agitating for their nation that he sees reason to call for this constitutional review or to change Nigeria's constitution? So number one, I want to say, no matter whatever you do, some people are not ready to leave this amalgamated evil entity called Nigeria. Because if they were ready to leave, this retired colonel will not ask that question. Because his speeches, he said, he knew that there are loopholes in Nigeria. Whether potholes, whether potter, or whatever he calls it. He's supposed to have started before now, before even Simon Ekpa started, because it's not today he drafted his constitution. And who has he rallied around with his constitution, or try to enforce the constitution of his to replace Nigeria on. So, but when we are talking, when you hear that Nigeria is a zoo, you think that the people are making a mistake. Everybody knows the truth, but everybody refuses to say the truth. Now, how can you and Simon Ekpa now close the loopholes and the potholes and the Potopoto holes in Nigeria. So when you talk of loopholes, let me tell you something. Number one loophole is Buhari. He has finished Nigeria money, turned Nigeria into even Somalia is better. Where can you compare Nigeria to? With which country on earth today? There's no country. If you come to corruption and criminality, Nigeria is number one. Nigeria government is number one in the whole world. Criminality and fraudulent 419, banditry, terrorism, Nigeria, number one. Yes. So now, are you going to start with the Tinubu who have decided to die in Asorok? Tinubu knows that he didn't win any election. But what is going on in Nigeria is religious politics and the tradition. Religion and tradition. There's nothing like politics. There's nothing like democracy. And that their religion does not have impunity. It does not have immunity. It's full of impunity. Their religion is full of impunity. It does not have immunity. It cannot protect the citizens. It cannot protect anybody. And that religion, they want to use the law of religion called Sharia, Sharia law. That's what they want to enact all over Nigeria. So every Nigerian, irrespective of the angle you are coming from, you must hit your head on the ground. Allahu Akbar. If not, you are not a Nigerian, because Nigeria has become Islamic State, terrorist country, a banditry country, cannibal country, whatever you like, name it. Their soldiers are not normal soldiers. Their police and DSS are fake, because all of them are terrorists on military uniform and police uniform. Find out, is it where you are going to start to change or to fill the potholes? All the lawmakers in Nigeria have joined Islamic extremists, because if not, you would have heard how they have arrested the extremists. Boko Haram, Al-Qaeda, ISWAP, ICC. You should have heard how they arrested them, prosecuted them, executed them, sentenced them. But because they are sponsoring them, because they are lawlessness country. So I want to say that a billion years to come, Nigeria can never be repaired to become a country. And who amongst you can live a billion years? None of you. Simon Eba answered him, asked him, are you a Christian or are you a Muslim? He said he's a Christian. Good, you are a Christian. Did you believe that Jesus Christ is the Lord and your personal Savior? He said yes, he believed. Then Simon Eba told him that even if Jesus Christ will come down, if you can call him to come and rule Nigeria and repair Nigeria, that Jesus Christ cannot be able to repair Nigeria. He won't be able to repair it because of the atrocious things that have been committed, and Nigeria is not ready to repent. Are you getting it now? Let me quickly give you a biblical injunction in the book of Genesis. And the Bible says, God regretted that he made a man. That means the King James Version, the old version said, and it repented, God repented that he made a man and it pained him in his heart.